Hi, my name is Omonivie Okhade. I am an artist and I am a part of a group show called Elemental Offerings. It is a group show with myself, Sarah Perez, and Vanessa Coburn. We are here at ARTHOUSE in Sacramento. And this show was very special. I'm so grateful to have been a part of it. And it opened this fall in November and it's closing tomorrow. So I wanted to take an opportunity to offer a bit of a virtual tour for those who couldn't make the show. So let's get started. Elemental Offerings is a concept that we, Sarah, Vanessa, and I discussed and came together with earlier this year. We all have aesthetics that are inspired by nature. Vanessa is a watercolor painter. Sarah is a metalsmith, and she has a beautiful body of work in Calder-esque mobiles and metal sculpture, and I up till now have been doing jewelry based in metals like silver and brass and copper, and so this was an opportunity for me to step outside of the little box that I created for myself and do a different medium of work, in this case sculpture. So we talked about the fact that our inspiration came from nature, so we kind of contemplated like what that meant for us. We talked about kind of the relevancy of it in the context of where we're at now with this global pandemic, and last year where we had to go under essentially lockdown. And we talked about how there was this kind of resurgence of nature, of animals coming out and feeling comfortable to roam the streets, and how bodies of water were clearing up in the absence of human activity and human production. So really wanted to kind of celebrate that, hone in on that, and kind of comment on how nature is resilient and strong, and we are really blessed and in a space where we can pause and understand that, you know, we're in this really, I guess we are the beneficiaries of blessings that we need to recognize and really respect. So that's kind of what this show is about. So as you can see, Vanessa's beautiful landscape is behind me. And yeah, all of our pieces really just go really well together. That's the simplest way I can explain. So yeah, so let's kind of look at some of the pieces, and hopefully, if you have any questions, you can email me. My email address is hello@tulaandbloom.com, and you're welcome to reach out for any questions or inquiries about purchasing a piece of mine. The artists, Sarah and Vanessa, each have their Instagram and websites, and you can also contact them for purchase inquiries. So we'll start here. So this is called Conversing. The way that I distilled the concepts that we've talked about into actual form is the idea of the resilience of the land and how grass can grow in any space. And so I noticed, I was observing grass, you know, pushing its way through concrete. And so that's kind of the theme that I went with in this show. And so most of my pieces are illustrative of that concept of grass making its way through what seems to be an impenetrable barrier. So that's conversing. Wanted to, I called it conversing because the root systems and how they can basically allow plants to communicate with each other. So that's conversing. Let me go here. This diptych is called In Process. So we have In Process 1 and In Process 2. These two pieces are related in that this is kind of like the beginnings of a transition and a taking over of this man-made creation and how it starts off kind of slow, but it shows, you know, that it's a process. And the second piece is, you know, after time, like what happens when nature and time come together. And so, yeah, just wanted to kind of tell a story in that sense. I used brass metal sheets to form cracks in the pavement. And again, using brass wire and sheets to create my sprouts, my grass forms. These pieces are pretty heavy. They could have been heavier. I did do some filler to offset the weight of the concrete. But that being said, they are substantial pieces. Next piece is called Resilience. And I want to say that was probably one of the first pieces that I thought of. Just the basic idea of like how, yeah, nature is resilient and it will find its way through whatever barriers are presented. And I really liked this idea of like this like little, like in whatever form, like it'll come through, and it might start small, but then it can kind of overtake. So yeah. And then the next piece, let's see, we'll start with this one. This is called Inevitable One. And as you can see, it's sold. And it's kind of a larger scale of, you know, this grass form bursting through concrete. And down below is Inevitable 2, and that's a more elaborate illustration. And finally, because wearable design jewelry has been my main gig for the last almost 10 years. I definitely wanted to include some wearables in the show. This piece that I created is a necklace called Abundance. And it is basically that idea of, you know, just the how fruitful the land can be. And so that's here. And it's made from brass sheet, brass tubing, and wax cord. those are my pieces. Sarah and Vanessa's work is amazing and beautiful, and I would love for them to describe it for themselves, but I will give you a show, a tour of the rest of the pieces in the show. Again, if you are interested in learning more about Sarah and Vanessa's work, you can contact them. Vanessa is Vanessa Coburn Art on Instagram. I think there's an underscore after Coburn. And Sarah is Electric Sun Creatives on Instagram. So this is Vanessa's work here. And personally, I mean, being able to see these pieces like come together and see the individual artists and how they took their concepts and took their specialized medium and how they illustrated what the concept meant for them was like really, I just love it so much. It's so beautiful. And it was just, when we put it together and had the opening reception, I just love how everything kind of came together and just I think the word that I'm looking for is harmony. Like there's a harmony in all of our work. We also talked about in terms of elemental offerings, and we talked about the different elements. You know, earth, fire, water, wind, and how in the different dimensions we have elements in the sky and elements on the land, elements in the water. And so we took those ideas and brought that dynamic into the show by having pieces on the floor, pieces on the wall, pieces in the air. And that's where you have some of Sarah's pieces. It's a multiple pieces that come together into this form called kelp forest. So I feel like with Sarah's work, it kind of went both water and air are represented here. Just a really beautiful show. I'm super grateful and super proud to be a part of it. Proud of Sarah and Vanessa, proud of myself for the work that we did and how we came together. And I want to express my gratitude to both of those ladies as well as the folks here at ARTHOUSE for welcoming us and allowing us to create this experience for everybody who could make it. And I hope you enjoy this tour. Again, my email, you can reach me at hello@tulainbloom, TulainBloom.com. And thank you for watching.